Hi everyone, thank you very much for joining me. We're currently in Florida at Daytona. So what I wanted to do today was take off and head south and head over towards the Kennedy Space Center. And I thought today would be a good day, obviously with the Artemis 1 mission being happening at the moment. It'd be a good time to have a look at the launch sites and see all the activity we can see around there. So we're going to take off now, and I'll join you again when we're in the air. And for those that are wondering, we're in the Cessna Grand Caravan. Taking off today, I say we're in Daytona. I think if we look over to the right, we'll see the Daytona Raceway. Oh, there we go. There's quite a bit of weather today, so we'll do some cloud hopping and try and avoid where we can. For some of it. But I will avoid it for some of it. But we've got our instruments as well, so we can see where we're going at least. Follow the coastline down all the way to Kennedy Space Center. Don't ease, I will descend. It's a bit bumpy. obviously would have been a YouTube video, please do feel free to skip through the cloud section. And I will see you over at Kennedy. Obviously we do get the brakes in the clouds and get a lovely view of the Florida skyline. So we're currently heading in a southerly direction. Continue to climb it and see what we see when we get down to Kennedy. For those of you that do have flight simulator, I do recommend flying the caravan. It's a fantastic aircraft to fly. Normally I fly this on a more of a longer journey, but I think it lends itself quite well to the views with the overwind as well, so. And it's just a fun aircraft to fly as well. We're just currently over the sea, so we get a good view over to our right, so if Kennedy won't get down there. And hopefully get to see the launch complexes. clouds are definitely patchy. I just hope that we do get a break when we get to down towards NASA and Kennedy. And if we don't, as I say, we will descend below the current level. It would just be nice to get a high up perspective on that. Clouds certainly do build in Florida. Okay, so as you can see just over there, it does say the NASA Shuttle landing facilities, 14 nautical miles, so we're nearly there now. Hopefully, if the cloud stays as it is, we'll get a good view of the launch complexes. But with Florida and clouds, we can never guarantee what's going to happen. SpaceX, I'm sure, has 39A. But do correct me if I'm wrong. Runway there, where the shuttle used to land. Interesting to know how long that runway actually is. So the looks huge. There's one now. Tell me in the comments which launch complex that is. That's 39A or 39B. Too sure. There's another one. In the break in the cloud, we are getting a fair view of them. We'll skirt around the coast and see what else we can see. Just bank over slightly. There's another launch complex just over on the horizon over there. This is fantastic. So if I just bank it over a little bit more. Let's say we're over 6,300 feet currently, so we're getting a really good view of the overall landscape of NASA Kennedy Space Center. Fantastic. sure that's the one that Artemis 1 SLS launches. And just over there I can see where the vehicle assembly building is. Absolutely fantastic. The clouds just broke in just the right place. Perfect. She sees off on the power button. Descend through this pathway. There's a shuttle landing runway just through the clouds. The rest of NASA's complex. I'm not mistaken, I think that might be Roberts Road, where SpaceX is building their new facilities. Just descended now, and let's get through this cloud line. I can see there's a little airport down there, so we'll aim to land there. So firstly, can I just thank you all for watching so far? Obviously the video's not finished, but if you've enjoyed what you've watched so far, then please do like the video, subscribe to the channel. It really helped me out massively, so thank you very much if you do that. But yeah, we'll aim to back on ourselves and land on that runway down there. So we're quite high up, so we'll do quite a long circuit. Yeah, definitely. subscribe and you'll get to be notified of future videos that I make. So I am planning on doing quite a few different videos of various places throughout the world, as well as in the near future. I will actually want to do a round the world video as well. I'm thinking possibly doing it in the caravan. So it's quite cloudy. It's going to make for an interesting approach. Still a bit high up here, so we'll just elongate this leg. Crosswind as well. So thank you once again for joining me on this video, and I look forward to seeing you again soon. As I say, please do subscribe to the channel and you'll get notified of future videos. So thank you very much and I'll see you all soon. Goodbye.